Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are in the midst of winter, and just because the weather is cooler doesn't mean our travel has to slow down. And here to give us the 411 on how to travel, even if you're doing it solo, is travel journalist Lisa Bonner. How are you, my dear?
I'm well, thank you.
Yes.
How are you?
I am so happy you're here, and I'm doing just fine. But I'm happy you're here. We talked a little bit while we were on break. Mm-hmm. I was like, listen, I need to get out. I need to do more. And to hear that it's okay for me to do it solo, it's very reassuring for me. So tell me some places. Where can I go?
There are so many places to go, and it really depends on what it is that you want to do. And we were just talking about a solo trip that you have coming up, but I have been to Cambodia. I have been to Paris by myself. I've been to Iceland. There's so many places to go and to choose from, and there are no shortage of things to do once you get there.
Wow, by yourself.
By myself.
What are some tips that you can give a person like me who's gonna start traveling by herself, who's a little green to it? My biggest fear, I'm afraid.
Right. Right.
Just to be honest.
And that
with
is
you.
Actually the number one reason why people do not go and travel solo. And I am a firm believer that everybody, especially every woman, should take a solo travel trip because you get to know yourself, you get to spend time for yourself with yourself. But one of the things that I think that is most important when you're starting out is to address your fears. It is really important so you can drill down on that because that way it will help you plan the perfect vacation.
Yeah.
And then you look into the specific vacation that you want to take. Mm-hmm. Are you interested in going to the beach?
Mm-hmm.
Are you interested in going hiking or on a yoga or wellness trip? And you look at your activity level. Do you want to chill out? And do you want to veg out? Or do you really want to get into the midst of the culture? Also, look, your trip will really depend on the weather. If you want to go to a beach, perhaps, you will not really want to go to the Caribbean, for example, during hurricane season.
Oh, absolutely not.
Right. So there are a lot of things to consider. And, you know, also, there are a lot of women who have taken solo travel trips, and all you have to do is reach out to one of your friends.
What do we need to do for safety? Because, again, that's my greatest fear.
Right.
Yeah, I would love to go, you know, but it's like, oh, I'm going to be by myself, you know, then random people are going to be talking to me.
Well, this is the question that I ask most people. Haven't you done something solo here?
Of course.
Okay, same thing. Are you scared?
But I'm familiar with the territory.
True,
here.
But there, you know, you reach out and you. I think the most important thing to do is look and see where you want to go and figure out if you are comfortable in going there. That's the most important thing.
Well, how can we get started?
Okay.
Because I'm going to suit up. I'm ready.
Okay. Well, we can get started by doing exactly what I told you. Know, we talked about before, addressing your fears, figuring out what it is that you want to do. Designing and tailoring the vacation that really works for you and really addressing everything that you want to do. Take a bucket list trip.
Ooh,
where is
good.
It that you have always wanted to go that you've never been? And here's something that I would tell people who might be gun shy in terms of planning an entire vacation by themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Tack it on to the beginning of it or the end of a trip that you may have gone to and then go to somewhere that's kind of close to there.
Yeah.
And that's a really perfect way to ease into it.
I like that. Well, give me some travel do's and don'ts.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, this is good because you are traveling by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You have the flexibility. So I am one who really absolutely believes in using an airline and amassing points on an airline or with a hotel or through your credit card. You have the time at this point to use the flexibility to look into defraying your costs through the trips of using points and using airline miles.
Yes.
So that's something that can defray the costs. If you are also looking to do something that might require you to book for two people, there are certain places that have reduced single supplements. And that's something that you can just look into the fine print or just go on, for example, and just look in to see who is going to waive a single supplement on a tour, for example.
Okay.
This is look into last minute deals on car and reservations.
Mm-hmm.
Look into travel consolidators like a Priceline or Airbnb.
Mm-hmm.
And if there's somewhere in there you really wanted to go, sign up for such watch apps as Hopper, Airfare Watchdog, and those will tell you about the prices, the variances, and the fluctuations in the ticket prices.
Hopper. Okay.
And Airfare Watchdog.
Okay, Airfare Watchdog.
And one also thing I want to say is consider a cruise.
Okay.
And I say this because you are never really alone as
that
much as
true.
You want to do. And you think you might be really
confined,
worried about,
taking
a trip with 4,000 other people on a big Royal Caribbean, but there are smaller. There are smaller cruise lines such as Windstar, or you can take a river cruise where they have a maximum person capacity of about 300 people.
Oh, okay,
and
great.
Then you have the shore excursions, and so you can sign up for those, and you're never really alone as much as you want.
I always love the excursions too.
See,
I do.
Great.
But do you have a tip on where I can find some cheap ones?
Well, like I said, we talked about Priceline. Uh-huh. I never used Priceline before because I thought it was the name your price thing.
Yeah.
But one of my travel friends actually told me that she took a trip to Monaco last year on Priceline, and she went on and got
You know, Monaco is very, very expensive.
Yes, it is, but she took a trip that she did the airfare and hotel and got it at a really reduced price. And I was looking for some of that over the holidays as well.
Wow.
They are some good deals out there. And don't let fear or not knowing what you have done or what you're in for deter you from taking the trip of a lifetime, because it's so fun.
Okay, she's speaking to my spirit right now. I got to tell you, Lisa, thank you so much. No, I really needed to hear that, because it's something that I've kind of been wanting to do, but then I'm like, who am I going to talk to? What am I going to do? Then I don't know these people. What if I get kidnapped? What if somebody kidnaps me? I don't know. I think about all these things, like, really. I got to tell you, I do.
But let people know where you're going. Leave an itinerary with people, and people will always know where to find you.
Y'all hit me up on WhatsApp. Check in on your girl.
That's
okay,
it.
Lisa, thank you so much.
We
really do appreciate you being here at the Sister Circle today, and thanks for all of the amazing tips.